Hello friends, in this video we will see nested components. So we have divided the nested components topic into two parts. The first part will cover how to nest two components, and the second part will cover how to do communication between those components or how to pass data between those components. So let's start with our first part. A component can be nested within another component. This arrangement arises when we have a small feature capable of creating a component and can be used or shared among multiple components. The nested components communicate with each other using input and output properties. We define a component to be nestable on below conditions. So there are some conditions which you can evaluate to decide whether a component can be nested or not. So these are the conditions. Its template only manages a fragment of larger view. It has a selector and can be used as a directive. It optionally communicates with its container. So these are the three conditions which you can evaluate before deciding whether a component can be nested or not. The child or small feature template can be reused as nested component to multiple components instead of implementing the same feature for all the components. Thus, nested components help us achieving reusability of code. For example, you have an application wherein you have three components. All three components requires the same code. Now, instead of implementing that same code in all three components, you can create a nested component and refer that nested component in all the three components. So by this way, you are not creating redundant code, you are achieving reusability of code. And if it in future there comes a scenario where you have to make changes in that common code, you don't have to change all the three components and test them. You just have to change the nested component and test the nested component. So you're basically saving your time and also achieving usability of code. Now this is the diagrammatic structure of two components. So one is the parent component, other is the child component. The outer or the parent component is known as container component. It has its template and class. The inner component or child component is basically nested component. We are going to nest that component in the container component. It also has its template and class. And how we basically nest a component into container component? So we nest a child component into container component by referring its directive name. So in this case, it's my hyphen star in the template of container component. So by this way, you basically nest two components. So we'll see through application how we can do that. The inner component is the nested or the child component, and the outer component is the parent or the container component. When developing an interactive application, the nested component often communicates with the container component. The nested component receives information from container component through input properties. The nested component outputs the information back to container by raising events. So this communication part we'll see in our next part. So you can see a picture or an image of grid. So we have already implemented this grid till DOB column, date of birth column. The next column is basically rating column, and we are going to implement this as a part of nested component. So let's start. First, let's go to our application. So this is our current state of our application, and we are using the same project which we have used in our all the previous videos. And this is the playlist.component.ts TypeScript file or playlist component class, and this is the template which is basically referred in this component class. And this playlist.html is responsible for rendering grid on the UI. So you can see a grid on the UI, so it is basically being rendered by this HTML template. So now we are going to implement one more column here. So let's do that. So in order to do that, first we have to go to our player TS, and we have to define one property, and we have to name it as rating, and let it be a number. Then we have to go to the service which is providing data for our collection of players. So we have to specify one more property here, rating. So you can see these red lines. So basically these are validations. So it is showing error that one of the property of the interface is not implemented. So we are implementing that. And for the second player, I am giving rating as 5. Now, once our interface changes are done, the data is also done, we have to bind this data to our template. So let's do that. So I'm going to create another table header, and I'm going to name it as our rating. And we have to go to the table data part. So I'll define one TD, and using interpolation, I will bind the rating of player. Now, if you go to the UI, you'll see rating in number. So now, if you remember, we have shown rating in stars. So basically, we will achieve the rating in stars at the end of our next part, where we will see how to communicate between two components. For now, we will just show the rating in numbers. Now, you will see that this arrangement is not nested, because this table data is part of this component's template itself. So now we will do, or we will achieve an arrangement where two components are nestable. So what we are going to do is, this binding thing, that this table data which is responsible for displaying data, we will make this part nestable. So let's see how we can do that. So for that, I will create another folder in the app folder, and I'm going to name it as nested. And inside this folder, I'm going to create a new TypeScript file. I'm going to name it as star dot, it is a component, dot ts, and we'll do the needful. So first I'm going to use export class star rating component. For now I'm not going to include anything. Then I'm going to import our component decorator from Angular core. Then I'm going to specify, or I'm going to decorate this class using component decorator, and I will specify the directive name using selector property, and directive name will be my star. Okay, and I will specify one template using template URL property, and my template will lie under app, under nested, and the name will be star.component.html following the convention. And I'm also going to have one CSS file for my component, specific for my component, and that we can specify using style URLs. So this accepts an array, and I will specify the path where my CSS file will stay. So CSS file name will be star.component.css. So now let's add these files. So I'll go to my nested folder. I will add one HTML page. I'm going to name it as star.component.html. And for now, I will just display hello, or you can say dummy rating 4 in bold. Then I will add one more file, that is stylesheet file. And I'm going to name it as star.component.css following the convention. For now, I will remove everything from this file. And now our component is ready. So we have template also, we have stylesheet file as well. Now before using, or before nesting this component, we have to register this component to our app module. So let's go to app module, and we'll do the needful. So I have to import my newly created component, that is star rating component. Okay, and then I have to specify the name of the file, and default extension it uses JS. Then I have to specify the star rating component in declarations array. So by this way, we will register our component, and we can use this component under app module. So now let's go to the parent component template. So this is the parent components template, and we are going to replace this table data with the directive name of our newly created template or newly created component. So our newly created component directive name is my-star. Okay, so now by this way, we have nested that child component into this container component by using, or by referring the directive name. So when Angular detects this directive name, it basically renders that component template into this table data. So now if you go to UI, you will see 4 rating in bold. Now let me go to child components template and make changes in the rating to 4.5. You will see change in the rating column. So by this way we have nested child component into parent component. But you must be wondering that we are not seeing stars. So we will see stars as a part of our next video, where we will see how to communicate between two components. So in this video, basically we have achieved how we can nest a child component into container component by referring its directive name in the container components template. So I hope you like this video. Thank you, friends.